year 1462, Constantinople had fallen. Muslim Turks swept into Europe with a vast superior force, striking at Romania, threatening all of Christendom. From Transylvania arose a Romanian knight of the Sacred Order of the Dragon, known as Draculia. On the eve of the battle, his bride, Elisabetta, whom he prized above all things on earth, knew that he must face an insurmountable force from which he might never return. The vengeful Turks shot an arrow into the castle, carrying false news of Draculia's death. Elisabetta, believing him dead, flung herself into the river.
My prince is dead. All is lost without him. May God unite us in heaven.
Asta e legea, lui Dumnezeu.
Asta e să răscoată al meu pentru apărarea bisericii.
Pe lege nu doar ce spați să răscoată
el,
ele-ți pe tine ca să vedeți. Dumnezeu! Am o ridicat din morți. Și răspund.
I've done everything that you asked, Master. All the preparations are in order. Everything. I await your command. For I know that when the rewards are given, I will be one of those who benefits from your generosity. Thank you.
Gone mad. Renfield is deranged. Lost his greedy mind, poor chap. I want you to take over for his foreign client, this rather eccentric Count Dracula. He's buying up property around London.
Of course, sir. I'll attend to the Count. Thank you for your confidence.
This is a great opportunity for you, Harker. But you'll have to leave Transylvania immediately. Opportunities such as this come but once in a lifetime.
Yes, of course, sir. If I may inquire, what, in fact, happened to Mr. Renfield in Transylvania?
Nothing. Nothing. Personal problems. Close these transactions, and your future with this firm is assured.
Yes, sir. I will give it my full attention.
We've waited this long, haven't we?
We can be married when I return.
Of course.
All right.
Jonathan. Jonathan, I love you.
I love you, Mina. Budapest. Left Budapest early this morning. The impression I had was that we were leaving the West and entering the East. The district I am to enter is in the extreme east of the country, just on the borders of three states, Transylvania, Moldavia, and Bukovina, in the midst of the Carpathian Mountains, one of the wildest and least known portions of Europe.
My friend. Welcome to the Carpathians. I am anxiously expecting you. At the Borgo Pass, my carriage will await you and bring you to me. I trust your journey from London has been a happy one, and that you will enjoy your stay in my beautiful land. Your friend, D.
Diary, 25th May. My dear Jonathan has been gone almost a week. And although I was disappointed we could not marry before his departure, I am happy that he got sent on this important assignment. I am longing to hear all the news. It must be so nice to see strange countries. I wonder if we, I mean Jonathan and I, shall ever see them together.
No one is here.
Pentru că morții umblă repede.
Thank you. I say, is the castle far?
Freely of your own will and leave some of the happiness you bring.
Count Dracula?
I am Dracula. And I bid you welcome, Mr. Harker, to my house. Come in.
Excuse me that I do not join you.
But I have already died. And I never drink wine.
An ancestor? I see a resemblance.
Order of the Dracul. The dragon. An ancient society pledging my forefathers to defend the church against all enemies of Christ. The relationship was not entirely successful.
Oh, yes.
It is no laughing matter. We, Dracul, have a right to be proud. What devil or witch was ever so great as Attila, whose blood flows in these veins? Blood. Is too precious a thing in these times. The warlike days are over. The victories of my great race are but a tale to be told. I am the last of my kind.
I have offended you with my ignorance, Count. Forgive me.
I do so long to go through the crowded streets of your mighty London, to be in the midst of the whirl and the rush of humanity. To share its life, its changes, its death.
There. You, Count, are the owner of Carfax Abbey at Purfleet. Congratulations.
Your firm writes most highly of your talents. They say you are a man of good taste. And that you are a worthy substitute to your predecessor, Mr. Renfield.
You may rely on me, Count. Forgive my curiosity, but why 10 houses in such precise locations around London? Is it to raise the market value?
Do you believe in destiny? That even the powers of time can be altered for a single purpose? The luckiest man who walks on this earth is the one who finds true love.
You found Mina. I thought she was lost. We're to be married as soon as I return. Are you married, Count? Sir, are you married?
I was married once. Ages ago, it seems. She died.
Oh. I'm very sorry.
She was fortunate. My life at its best is misery. She will no doubt make a devoted wife. And you a faithful husband.
Come. Write now, my friend, to your firm. And to any loved ones, and say that it shall please you to stay with me. Until a month from now.
A month? Do you wish me to stay so long?
I will take no refusal.
Diary, 30th of May, 1897. I know that Jonathan does not want me to stay here with Lucy while he is away. He thinks that if I become accustomed to the wealth and privileges of the Westenra family, I will not be content as the wife of a mere clerk in a law firm. But Lucy and I have been friends since we were children, and she has never minded that I am only a schoolmistress. Disgustingly awful.
Mina! Mina! Oh, Mina, you're always working. Is your ambitious John Harker forcing you to learn that ridiculous machine? When he could be forcing you to perform unspeakable acts of desperate passion on the parlor floor.
Lucy, really? You shouldn't talk about my fiancé in such a way. There's more to marriage than carnal pleasures.
Mina. So I see. Much, much more.
Oh.
Oh, that's...
Oh. What is it, Lucy? Because I don't understand it.
Can man and woman really do
that? I did. Only last night.
Fibber, you did not.
Yes, I did. Well, in my dreams. Jonathan measures up, doesn't he? You can tell Lucy.
We've kissed, that's all. He thinks he's too poor to marry me. It's all the worse now that I'm here visiting you at Hillingham, my rich friend.
Yes. But not even one marriage proposal. But here I am, almost 20. Practically a hag. Oh, look. What is that? A Texan. Quincy P. Morris. He's so young and fresh. Wild stallion between my legs.
You're positively indecent.
I just know what men desire. Watch.
Lucy.
Quincy, darling.
Miss Lucy. Why, you're as fresh as a spring rain.
Oh, thank you. Oh, Quincy. Please let me touch it. It's so big.
Little girl. Oh, my dear, sweet little girl. I hold your hand. And you've kissed me.
Jack! Oceans of love. Oh, Jack, my dog. Oh, poor little baby. Oh, my kitten, come over here. Come over here and I'll kiss it better. My poor little blossom. My poor little doctor. Brilliant doctor.
No, Quincy.
Jack.
What a naughty bear. Let me feel your
Arthur Homewood, Esquire.
Arthur! Oh, my darling.
Oh,
you're I'm so sorry about your hat.
Absolutely.
Mm.
Sharp.
My dress.
Absolutely.
It's my snake dress.
Is it really?
Lucy is a pure and virtuous girl, but I admit that her free way of speaking shocks me sometimes. Jonathan says it is a defect of the aristocracy that they say what they please. The truth is that I admire Lucy, and I'm not surprised that men flock around her. I wish I were as pretty and as adored as she.
Pujesz, dragoste. Věc mi.
What manner of man is this? R. M. Renfield, successful solicitor in the firm of Hawkins and Tompkins, respected member of the Lord Nugent's Wyndham Club, returns from business abroad in Transylvania. Promptly suffers a complete mental breakdown. He's now obsessed with some bloodlust.
George! Wait here.
Would you care for an order, Dr. Theod, or canapé?
No, thank you, Mr. Renfield. How are you feeling tonight?
Far better than you, my lovesick doctor.
Is my personal life of interest to you?
Of course it is. All life interests me.
Your diet, Mr. Renfield, is disgusting.
Actually, they're perfectly nutritious. You see, it's life that I ingest. Gives back life to me.
A fly gives you life.
Certainly. But you might as well ask a man to eat molecules with a pair of chopsticks than to interest me in lesser carnivora.
I shall have to invent a new classification of a lunatic for you. What about spiders? Spiders eat the flies.
Yes, spiders eat them.
What about sparrows?
Oh, yes. Did you say sparrows?
Something larger, perhaps?
Oh, yes. A kitten. I beg you. A little sleek. A playful kitten. Something I can teach. Something I can feed. No one would refuse me a kitten.
Wouldn't you prefer a cat?
Salvation depends upon it.
Your salvation?
Yes. I need lives. I need lives for the master.
Master? What master?
The master will come. And he has promised to make me immortal.
How?
May, Castle Dracula. I think strange things which I dare not confess to my own soul. The Count. The way he looked at Mina's picture fills me with dread, as if I have a part to play in a story that is not known to me.
I didn't hear you come in.
Take care how you cut yourself.
It is more dangerous than you think. A foul bone of men's vanity. Perhaps you should grow a beard. The letters I requested, have you written them? Good. Should you leave these rooms? You will not by any chance go to sleep in any other part of the castle. It is old and has many bad memories. Be warned.
I'm sure I understand.
Do not put your faith in such trinkets of deceit. We are in Transylvania, and Transylvania is not England. Our ways are not your ways. And to you, there shall be many strange things.
I've seen many strange things already. Bloody wolves chasing me through some blue inferno.
Listen to them. That you did not mind. What sweet music, Thangmark.
Music? Those animals? I did as Dracula instructed. I wrote three letters. To the firm, to my family, and to my beloved Mina. I said nothing of my fears, as he will read them, no doubt. I know now that I am a prisoner. Thank you.
это сейчас на рачес борба думья подсина.
То, наивный туда, то наисовершенный туда.
Ну я дврат, съел поцию беск, съесю беск, динау.
N-ai nimic pentru noi în seara asta.
Dearest Mina, all is well here. The Count has insisted I remain for a month to tutor him in English custom. I can say no more, except I love you. Ever faithful, Jonathan. The letters I have written have undoubtedly sealed my doom. The Count's gypsies, fearless warriors who are loyal to the death to whatever nobleman they serve. Day and night they toil, filling boxes with decrepit earth from the bowels of the castle. They are to be delivered to his newly acquired Carfax Abbey in London. Why do they fill these boxes with earth?
I love him! I love him! Oh, Mina! It's so wonderful, I've decided! I love him and I've said yes!
So finally, don't tell me. The Texan with the big knife.
Oh, no. To my dear number three, Lord Arthur Homewood. Lord and Lady Homewood. And you ought to be my maid of honor. Oh, say yes.
Mina, what is it? It's the most exciting day of my life. You don't seem to care.
It's just that I'm so terribly worried about Jonathan. This letter I received is so... It's so cold. It's so unnatural. It's not like him at all.
Oh, Mina, don't worry.
Captain's log, the Demeter, 27th June, 1897. We picked up 50 boxes of experimental earth bound for London, England. Set sail at noon into a storm that seemed to come out of nowhere, carrying us out to sea. Has gone missing, nearing Gibraltar. Storm continues, crew uneasy. Believes someone or something is aboard the ship with us.
Bidding, master. I have worshipped you. Fucking morons know that you are near! Master! I am your slave! I await your command!
The case of Renfield grows more interesting. Yet there is method in his madness, with his flies and spiders. Had I the secret of even one such brilliant mind, the key to the fancy of one lunatic.
Lucy.
Lucy.
Agonizing feeling, and when you came back to me, I saw you shaking.
It's all right, Lizzie, you're killing me.
I had to, it sort of pulled me and lured me, and I had no control. Red eyes. I still have the taste of his blood on my mouth.
Contrary to some beliefs, the vampire, like any other night creature, can move about by day, though it is not his natural time, and his powers are weak.
see me. See me now.
Strikes England. Escape wolf from Zeus, still at large. Bye, Fletcher, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Get your gazette, penny and paper.
My humblest apologies, sir. Forgive my ignorance, sir.
I am, you recently arrived from abroad, and I do not know your city. It's a beautiful lady.
You may purchase a street atlas for sixpence. Good day.
I have offended you. I am only looking for the cinematograph. I understand it is a wonder of the civilized world.
If you seek culture, then visit a museum. London is filled. Excuse me.
A woman so lovely and intelligent should not be walking the streets of London without her gentleman.
Do I know you, sir? Are you acquainted with my husband? Shall I call the police?
Husband, I shall bother you no more.
Sir, it is I who have been rude. If you're looking...
Please. Permit me to introduce myself. I am Prince Vlad of Sangai.
Prince Nevers.
I am your servant.
Wilhelmina Murray.
I am honored, Madam Mina.
This way.
Hello. Mr. Holmwood asked me to stop by to see Miss Lucy.
Yes. Dr. Seward, Miss Lucy.
Thank you.
Oh, Jack. Brilliant, Jack. Do you like it?
Did Arthur put you up to this? Or did you want me alone just once before I married?
Lucy, you're embarrassing me. I'm here as your doctor.
Your fiancé is very worried about you, and I assure you, a doctor's confidence is sacred. I must have your complete trust.
Help me, Jack. I don't know what's happening to me. I'm changing. I can feel it. I can hear everything. I hear the servants at the other end of the house whispering. I hear mice in the attic stomping like elephants. I'm having horrible nightmares, Jack. The eyes. Jack.
I'm here, Lucy. Oh. Nothing will harm you.
Jack. Ow.
Ow. Let it work.
Oh. Thank you.
Lucy.
Oh, Jack, kiss me. Oh.
And may I say, Miss Lucy is hotter than a June bride riding bareback buck naked in the middle of the Sahara.
I would watch my colonial tongue if I were you.
Hello, Jack. And how's our lovely patient today?
Well, frankly, Arthur, I'm confounded.
Oh, Jack, are you still brooding over Miss Lucy?
I can only conclude it must be something mental.
How very droll. Do you hear that, Quince? Last week he wanted to marry her. Now he wants to have her committed. Let's go and have a look at her, shall we?
I am at a loss, I admit. I've taken the liberty of cabling Abraham von Helsing, the metaphysician philosopher.
Sounds like a goddamn witch doctor to me, Jack.
Von Helsing knows more about obscure diseases than any man in the world. He's my teacher and mentor.
Do it, man. Bring him here. Spare no expense.
Astounding. There are no limits to science.
How can you call this science? Do you think Madame Curie would invite such comparisons? Really? I shouldn't have come here. I must go.
Do not fear me.
Stop this! Stop this! Stop this!
Donesh Dragos, the Vietzimele. Vietzimele. Oceans of time to find. There is much to be learned from beasts.
Now, the tropical pampas vampire bat must consume 10 times its own weight in fresh blood each day. Its own blood cells will die.
Cute little vermin, yeah?
Blood and the diseases of the blood, such as syphilis, that concern us here. The very name venereal diseases, the diseases of Venus, imputes to them divine origin, and they are involved in that sex problem about which the ethics and ideals of Christian civilization are concerned. In fact, civilization and syphilization have advanced together. What's this?
It's from the Telegraph, Professor.
Telegraph? Hmm.
Thank you. Gentlemen, thank you. That will be all.
Dawn. These may be the last words I write in this journal. Dracula has left me with these women. These devils of the pit. They drain my blood to keep me weak, barely alive so I cannot escape. I will try one last time today to escape through the water. There must be passageway to the river. And then away from this cursed land, where the devil and his children still walk with earthly feet.
Record, I do attest that at this point I, Abraham van Helsing, became personally involved in these strange events.
Professor van Helsing, how good of you to come.
I always come to my friends in need when they call me. So, Jack, tell me everything about your case.
She has all the usual physical anemic signs.
Yeah?
Her blood analyze is normal, and yet it is not. She manifests continued blood loss. I cannot trace the cause.
Blood loss how? My God, close the doors. My God, she's only a child. Yeah. My God. There's no time to be lost. Must be a transfusion at once. Take off your coat. Remember how to tie a tourniquet, don't you? Or have you forgotten?
You perfected a procedure?
Perfected? No, I've only experimented. Landsteiner's method. Animals, goats, sheep. If hemolysis occurs in the blood on the serum, her red blood cells will explode. She will die. Here, take this tube.
What in God's name is going on up here?
This is Professor van Helsing, Art.
What the hell is he doing to Luce?
He's trying to save her life.
Good God.
You're the fiancé? Please. Please. Take off your coat. This young lady is very ill. She's dying. She wants blood, and blood she must have. Take off your coat.
Roll up your sleeve, Art.
Oh, God.
Quickly, quickly, quickly.
Roll it up.
This may hurt a little, Art.
Thank you.
Forgive me, sir. My life is hers. I would give my last drop of blood to save her.
Your last drop? Thank you. You're very welcome here. I do not ask as much as that. Not yet.
Hold her hand.
But, Jack, that poor creature has had the blood of two men put into her already.
Man alive. Her whole body couldn't hold that much blood. What took it out?
It's a good question, Mr. Morris.
Those marks on her throat. No disease, no trituration. I'm sure the blood loss occurred there.
Oh? Where did the blood go? You were once a careful student, Jack. Use your brain. Where did the blood go? Tell me.
The bedclothes would be covered in blood.
Exactly. You do not let your eyes see nor your ears hear that which you cannot account for.
Something just went up there, sucked it out of her, and flew away, I suppose.
Yeah? Why not?
That's brilliant. That's absolutely brilliant. Will one of you learned doctors or whatever you are kindly tell me what is going on with my Lucy?
Jack, you are a scientist. Do you not think there are things in this universe which you cannot understand and which are true? Mesmerism, hypnotism,
you and Sharkle
electromagnetic fields, materialization, astral bodies.
Professor?
Where the hell did he go? You see?
I feel like a blundering novice.
Gentlemen, we're not fighting some disease here. Those marks on your dear Miss Lucy's neck were made by something unspeakable out there. Dead, but not dead. It stalks us for some dread purpose I do not yet comprehend. To live, it feeds on Lucy's precious blood. It is a beast. A monster.
What is happening to Lucy and to me? When I was younger, my feelings were never troubled. I wish I were myself again. The sensible mean I always depended on.
Absence is the aphrodisiac of the cell. The green fairy who lives in the absence wants your soul. You are safe with me.
Tell me, Prince. Tell me of your home.
The most beautiful place in all creation.
Must be. A land beyond a great, vast forest. Surrounded by majestic mountains. Lush vineyards. Flowers of such frailty and beauty is to be found nowhere.
You describe my home as if you had seen it firsthand.
It's your voice, perhaps. It's so familiar. It's like a voice in a dream I cannot place. And it comforts me when I am alone.
No, no.
And what of the princess?
Princess?
There is always a princess. With gowns flowing white. And her face. River. The princess, she's a river filled with tears of sadness and heartbreak.
There was a princess. Elisabetta. She was the most radiant woman in all the empires of the world. Man's deceit took her from her ancient prince. She leapt to her death into the river that you spoke of. In my mother's tongue, it is called Archish. River Princess.
Dear Madame, your fiancé is safe and in the care of the good sisters of the Blessed Sacrament. Mr. Harker believes your life is in extreme danger, and he desires with all urgency that you join him here so that you may immediately be married. Yours with all blessings, Sister Agatha.
Jonathan must never know of us. Lucy! Lucy!
Abraham Van Helsing.
Dr. Van Helsing.
You're Madame Mina, dear friend to our Lucy, yeah?
How is she, Doctor?
She's still very weak. She tells me of your beloved Jonathan Harker and your worry for him. Well, I too worry for all young lovers. La da da da. Then darkness is in life, my child, and there are lights. And you are one of the lights, dear Mina, the light of all light. Go now to your friend.
Mina. Look, dear.
different, Mina. You look positively radiant. You heard from Jonathan, didn't
you? Yes. Yes. Mm. He's safe, Lucy. He's in a convent in Romania. He's suffering from a violent brain fever. The good sisters caring for him, they wrote to me and they say he needs me. But I won't go. I'm not going to leave him.
Mina, you've got to go to him. You've got to love him and marry him right then and there. And I want you to take this, my sister.
No.
Don't worry about spoiled little Lucy. I'll be all right. Tell Jonathan notions of love.
Jack?
Quincy.
How is she?
Medicinal. If you sleep, Lucy. You better dream.
He's got it!
Lucy.
He's not even
gone.
Got it!
Lucy, Quincy's here. Quincy's here to see you. Brandon, get some breath.
Oh, Quincy.
Now, Miss Lucy. Miss Lucy, you just rest easy. Arthur sent me to take care of you. He said if you don't get better right quick, I have to put you out of your misery like a lame horse.
Here occurs the shocking and frightening history of the wild berserker Prince Dracula. How he impaled people and roasted them, boiled their heads in the kettle. How he skinned them alive and hacked them to pieces and then drank their blood. Yeah. Dracula. For blood is the life.
My dearest prince, forgive me. I have received word from my fiancé in Romania. I am en route to join him. We are to be married. I will never see you again. Mina. It is odd, but I feel almost that my strange friend is with me. He speaks to me in my thoughts. With him, I felt more alive than ever I had. And now, without him, soon to be a bride, I feel confused and lost. Perhaps, though I try to be good, I am bad. Perhaps I am a bad, inconstant woman.
Vince!
the cause. It's cost my soul. It is Dracula, the undead, the foe I have pursued all my life. Dracula!
Jack, hurry! I've much to tell you!
Guard well, Mr. Morris. Do not fail here tonight. We are dealing with forces beyond all human experience and enormous power. So guard her well. Otherwise, your precious Lucy will become a bitch of the devil. A horn of darkness.
Well, you're a sick old buzzard.
Here we are, young man. Lucy is not a random victim attacked by mere accident, you understand? No. She's a willing recruit, a breathless follower, a wanton follower. I dare say, a devoted disciple. She is the devil's concubine! You understand me?
Yes. We may still save her precious soul. But not on an empty stomach. Jeff!
Here, sir.
Ah, I starve. Feed me.
Whoa, two!
Okay. There.
Your impotent men with their foolish spells cannot protect you from my power.
Second una roba lui Dumnezeu mina, cu robul lui Dumnezeu Ionatan, în numele Tatălui și al Fiului și al Sfântului Duh.
I condemn you to living death, to eternal hunger for living blood.
Yeah!
I know how deeply you loved her. That is why you must trust me and believe.
Believe? How can I believe?
I want you to bring me before nightfall a set of post-mortem knives.
An autopsy? Lucy?
No, 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 not exactly. I just want to cut off her head and take out her heart.
Diary, 17th September. Poor Jonathan. Still so ill. Is cheered by the familiar streets of London. For me, now that Lucy is dead, it is a sad homecoming. It is as if a part of me is dead too, except for the tiny hope that lives in me that I will again see my prince. Is he here? Now that I am married, I begin to understand the nature of my feelings for my strange friend, who was always in my thoughts. Jonathan, what is it?
It is the man himself.
There.
Look, he's grown young.
Gentlemen, must we desecrate poor Lucy's grave? She died horribly enough.
If Miss Lucy is dead, then no wrong can be done to her. But if she's not dead, well...
What are you saying, man? That she's been buried alive?
No. All I say is, she's undead. Undead. Gentlemen, shall we? One, two, three.
Where is she?
She lives beyond the grace of God, a wanderer in the outer darkness. She's vampire, Nosferatu. These creatures do not die like the bee after the first sting, but instead grow strong and become immortal once infected by another Nosferatu. So, my friends, we fight not one beast, but legions that go on age after age after age, feeding on the blood of the living.
Lucy!
Come to me, Arthur. Leave these others and come to me. My arms are hungry for you, my darling. Kiss me and caress me. My darling husband, please.
Let this hold you back. You're strong in the Lord. In the power of his might. You're strong in the Lord. In the power of his might. The power of God is upon us. We are strong in the Lord and the power of his might. We are strong in the Lord and the power of his might. We are strong in the Lord and the power of his might. Ex umbris in lucha. I bring you from shadow into light. I cast you out, the prince of darkness, into hell.
A moment's courage and it is done. Take the stick in your left hand. Place the point over the heart. Then in God's name, strike. Do it now! Ah!
Yeah!
Eat, feast. You'll need your strength for the dark days ahead. Mina?
Doctor?
Yeah?
How did Lucy die?
Huh?
Was she in great pain?
Yeah, she was in great pain. Then we cut off her head and drove a stake to her heart and burned it, and then she found peace.
Doctor! Please.
So, Mr. Harker, I must now ask you, as your doctor, a sensitive question. During your infidelity with those creatures, those demonic women, did you for one instant taste of their blood?
No.
No?
No.
Good. Then you have not infected your blood with the terrible disease that destroyed poor Lucy.
Doctor, you must understand. I doubted everything, even my mind. I was impotent with fear.
I know.
But, sir, I know where the bastard sleeps. I brought him there, to Carfax Abbey.
Vampires do exist. And this one we fight, this one we face, has the strength of 20 or more people. And you can testify for that, Mr. Harker.
But he can also control the meaner things of life, the bat, the rodent, the wolf. He can appear as mist, as vapor, as fog, and vanish at will.
Now, all these things Dracula can do, but he is not free. He must rest on the sacred earth of his homeland to gain his evil power. It is here that we must find him and destroy him utterly. Jack?
I almost feel pity for anything so hunted as this Count.
How can you pity such a creature?
I'll take Mina to my quarters.
Good.
You'll be safer there.
Mr. Morris, your bullets will not harm him. He must be beheaded. I suggest you use your big Bowie knife.
Well, I wasn't planning on getting that close, Doc.
Master! 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 Dr. Jack! I've been promised eternal life!
Dr. Seward, who is that man?
Mr. Renfield. This is no place for you, Madam Mina.
Renfield. I must see him.
Mr. Renfield, behave yourself. This is Mrs. Harker.
Good evening.
Good evening, Mr. Renfield.
Seems I've been rather naughty. I know you. You're the bride my master covets.
I have a husband. I am Mrs. Harker.
My master tells me about you.
What does he tell you?
That he is coming. That he is coming for you. Please. Don't stay here. Get away from these men. Please. And I pray to God I may never see your sweet face again. And may the Lord bless and keep you. Master, you promised me eternal life, but you give it to the pretty woman. Dr. Jack! I'm no lunatic man, I'm a sane man fighting for his soul.
My quarters are spare, but I think you will find them comfortable.
Dr. Jack!
Water and toiletries at your disposal. You'll be completely safe here.
Destroy every box, sterilize the earth inside, leave him no refuge. Let the exorcism begin. Your taste happens antiquate. Your defem. Before met, motu orum. Naturum. Naturum mundi. Hem. Qui habitat. Gehenam. Ut cum metu festinis. Gehenas!
Precious life.
I've wanted this to happen. I know that now. I want to be with you always.
You
cannot know what you are saying.
Yes, I do know. Feel your touch again. I thought you were dead.
There is no life in this body.
But you live. You live. What are you? I must know. You must tell me.
I am nothing. Lifeless. Soulless.
What do you mean?
Hated and feared. I am dead to all the world. I am the monster the breathing men would kill. I am Dracula.
I want to be what you are, see what you see, love what you love.
Miner, to work with me, you must die to your rising life and be reborn to mine.
You are my love. And my life always.
Then I give you life eternal. Everlasting love. The power of the storm and the beasts of the earth. Walk with me. To be my loving wife forever.
I will, yes. Yes.
Not let this be.
Please, I don't care. Make me.
Are you the cursed as I am to walk in the shadow of death for all eternity? I love you too much to condemn you.
Take me away from all this death.
Thank you.
You think you can destroy me? You're
sacred blood of Christ!
I who served the cross. I who commanded this hundreds of years before you were born.
Your armies were defeated. You tortured and impaled thousands of people.
I was betrayed. Look what your god has done to me.
No, your war with God is over. You must pay for your crimes. Christ compels you.
He is now my bride.
They must be burnt.
We have learned something much. Draculia fears us. He fears time. For if not, why does he hurry so?
He is gone.
How do you know?
He speaks to me.
He has a strong mind connection to you. His heart was strong enough to survive the grave.
You admire him.
Yeah. He was in life a most remarkable man. His mind was great and powerful, but greater is the necessity to stamp him out and destroy him utterly.
Doctor.
Yeah.
I know that I am becoming like him.
Your salvation is his destruction. That is why I want to hypnotize you. I want you to help me find him, Mina. Before it is too late, please help me find him. Please. Look into this light. The light of all light, into this flame. Your eyes are heavy. You want to sleep. Sleep now. Sleep.
Let's go to him.
What you hear? What you hear, child? What you hear?
Oh, my prince is calling me. He is traveling across icy seas to his beloved home. There he will grow strong again. I am coming to him to partake of his strength.
We left London by train and crossed the English Channel that night in stormy seas, no doubt from the passage of the Count's ship. He commands the winds, but we still have the advantage. By train, we can reach the Romanian port at Varna in 3 days. By ship, it will take him at least a week. From Paris, we traveled through the Alps to Budapest. The Count must sail round the Rock of Gibraltar, where we have posted a lookout, and then on to the Black Sea port at Varna, where we will meet his ship and burn it into the sea.
The vampire has baptized her with his own blood. Her blood is dying, my friend.
It is no use.
Mina. We'll not let you go into the unknown alone.
Oh, my dear Jonathan. What have I done to you?
No. No, no, I have done this to both of us.
I can hear him. He's coming closer. He's calling me to him.
Mina. Mina.
please.
It's so cold.
Noon. Homewood received a wire from his clerk at Lloyd's. The Count's ship sailed past us in the night fog to the northern port of Galatz. The Black Devil is reading Mina's mind.
How can we catch him now?
Varna. Galatz. It's about 200 miles. I think that with the horses we can cut him off. Reach him before he reaches the castle. I will dispatch Van Helsing straight for the Borgo Pass. If we fail in our task, you will have to finish him. From Varna, Mina and Van Helsing took a carriage, and we continued on the train towards Galatz, where we still hoped to intercept the Count before he reaches land. I am fearful for Mina. She is now our decoy.
I know this place.
The end of the world.
We must go on.
It's late, child. We must rest here now.
No! We must go.
Mina!
He needs me. Mina. We must go!
We are past Bistrița. Dracula has outsmarted us again. We learned that his gypsies took charge of the vampire's box at Galatz and are now on the Borgo Pass road.
Here, you must eat.
I am not hungry.
Mina!
You've been so good to me, Professor. I know that Lucy harbored secret desires for you. She told me. I do know what men desire. My heart as you did poor Lucy, you murdering bastard.
Not while I live. I've sworn to protect you.
Mundi! Safer than the circle. I've lost Lucy. I will not lose you to him. Yours are Satan!
J'avoue venim noi.
This is holy blood! Leave this place now! Leave! Name of God! Leave this gun! I command you in the name of Christ! No!
Daniel!
racing against the sunset. Maybe too late, God help us.
Let them go. Our work is finished here. Hers has just begun.
Quincy. We've all become God's madmen. All of us.
Oh, my love.
I love.
There, in the presence of God, I understood at last how my love could release us all from the powers of darkness. Our love is stronger than death.
Give me. shine.